Good morning, my dear students. Welcome back after the vacation. I hope you are happy and healthy and staying safe at your homes. Today, I, Parul Tomar, your English teacher, have brought to you Chapter 4 of English 2, The Parrot Who Would Not Talk. This is an interesting story about a parrot and his behavior. I hope you will enjoy this. So, let's start the chapter. As I have already told you, this is chapter 4, The Parrot Who Would Not Talk. In the current slide, just see carefully the picture of two parrots who look alike is given. But if you will see closely, there are five differences. You have to find those five differences. This is a small activity before starting the chapter to warm you up so that you can enjoy the chapter better. So, look for the five differences. Let's search it together. The first one is the crown of the parrot. The second one is the second leg of the parrot. The third one is number of leaves in his crown. The fourth one is the shape of the wings. In the right side, there is no wing. And the last one, the beak of the parrot is smaller of left than the right one. If you can find some more, try it. So, let's start the reading. Let's read a story about a parrot that was not quite like other parrots. Means that was different. When I was growing up in Missouri, almost everyone kept a pet parrot or parakeet. Sometimes these birds became great talkers. They would say things like study, child, study, or don't be greedy, don't be greedy. These words were picked up by the bird after some members of the household had repeated them many times in front of him. But our parrot refused to talk. Refuse means not willing. So, what the writer is saying here? That he was growing up in Missouri and it was a fashion at that time to keep a pet parrot or parakeet. Parakeet is also a type of parrot. And why people used to keep them? Because these birds can be great talkers. They can speak some specific words by learning from the family members. They imitate humans and human voice. And what are the words they can talk? Study, child, study. Don't be greedy, etc. But the parrot narrator had, he totally refused to talk. He don't want it to talk. Now, let's go forward. He had been bought by Aunt Ruby from a bird catcher who had visited all the houses on our road. Granny and grandfather were not keen on keeping a caged bird as a pet, but Aunt Ruby insisted. Insisted means did not listen and argued or forcing to do something. Bird catcher, a person who catches the birds. Keen, not excited. So, she bought the parrot and tried to teach him to talk, but the parrot did not like her at all. Kiss, kiss, she would say, putting her face close to the bars of the cage. But The parrot would back away with anger. So what happens next? He had an aunt. Her name was Aunt Ruby. She purchased a pet bird from a bird catcher who was trying to sell the bird on road and was asking every house near narrator's house. Narrator's grandfather and grandmother were not interested in keeping the caged bird. Caged birds, birds which are kept in cage. But Aunt Ruby wanted to keep the parrot. She was adamant, and so she argued to keep the parrot. She brought the parrot home and tried to teach him to talk, but the parrot did not like her. For unknown reasons, the parrot do not wanted to talk. And for what she used to say? She used to say kiss, kiss. So that, and she was putting her face close to the bars of the cage so the parrot can kiss her. But the parrot disliked her. And when she used to do that, he was very angry and he used to back away with anger. So, what happened next? Let's continue. One day, the parrot suddenly dived forward and knocked Aunt Ruby's spectacles off her nose. Knock means struck. After that, she did not like the parrot anymore. She started making faces at him and calling out, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." Grandmother then put me in charge of feeding the parrot. He was quite happy to take green chilies and ripe tomatoes from my hands. I also gave him slices of mango. This gave me the chance to eat a few mangoes myself. There is a question in the box. How was Aunt Ruby's parrot different from other pet parrots? How it was different? He was not ready to talk. Other parrots talk. But he was not ready to talk, so he was different from other parrots. And what was happening? When Aunt Ruby used to bring her face forward and ask him to kiss kiss, one day the parrot was really angry. He came forward and knocked Aunt Ruby's spectacles off her nose. And he really hurted her bad. After that, she also started disliking the parrot. After seeing him, as soon as she used to see him, he used to make faces at him. And she used to say, "You are useless, you can't talk, can't sing, can't dance. Good for nothing." So because she started disliking the parrot, grandmother put the narrator in charge for feeding the parrot. As it was a caged bird, we need to feed it, right? It can't fly. So how he will eat? So narrator used to feed him. And the parrot really liked to eat green chilies and ripe tomatoes. And sometimes the narrator used to give him slices of mango also. And while feeding him mangoes, the narrator himself also was enjoying few slices of mangoes. So, by seeing the picture, you can guess what happened next. The cage is open. The small little boy is standing surprised, shocked, and the parrot is flying out of the cage. Yes, this is what happened next. One afternoon, while everyone was in the dining room, I gave the parrot his lunch. By mistake, I left the cage open. Seconds later, the bird was winging its way into the freedom of the mango orchard. Winging means flying. At the same time, grandfather came into the veranda and remarked, "I see your aunt's parrot has escaped." Veranda means an open space in front of the house with the railing around it. The door was quite loose, I said with a shrug. Aunt Ruby was upset. I thought we would never see the parrot again. But a few days later, I found the bird sitting on the veranda railing. Unselfishly, I gave the parrot half of my mango. So let's explain. What happened one afternoon when everyone was having lunch in the dining room? The narrator, the little boy who's telling the story, he gave the parrot his lunch as grandmother has appointed him for giving the bird lunch. But by mistake, he left the cage open and immediately the bird made its way and fly away in the mango garden, mango orchard. And when the bird fly away, at the same moment, grandfather also came into the veranda and saw it and told, "I have seen that your aunt's parrot has escaped." The narrator was surprised and scared at the same time, and he immediately said the door was quite loose to just tell grandfather that it was not entirely his fault. Grandfather, Aunt Ruby after that was really upset because her bird fly away, and the narrator thought that he would never see the parrot again. But after a few days, he saw the bird sitting on the veranda railing, and because he liked the parrot and parrot liked him, he unselfishly, without thinking, gave the parrot half of his mango slice because parrot used to like the eating the mango. So, let's go forward in the story. While the bird was enjoying the mango, Aunt Ruby came out of her room and cried out, "Look, there is my parrot. He must have missed me." With a loud squeak, the parrot flew out of her reach and perched on the nearest rose bush. Squeak means a loud noise made by a bird. He glared at Aunt Ruby and screamed at her in my aunt's familiar tones, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." There's a question in the box. When Aunt Ruby saw that the parrot had come back, and what did she think? She thought that parrot had come back because he was missing her, though it was her mistake. It was not the reason. So when the bird was enjoying the mango, Aunt Ruby came out of her room and she thought that seeing the parrot, her parrot missed her, so he has come back. But as soon as parrot saw Aunt Ruby, he made a loud sound which birds make and flew away far from her and sat on the nearest rose bush. He glared at Aunt Ruby and shouted at her in Aunt's familiar tone. What Aunt Ruby used to tell him? "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance." And parrots imitate human. She was always saying that to him, and that he learned from Aunt Ruby and said as soon as he saw Aunt Ruby. Aunt Ruby went ruby red and ran inside her room. But that was not the end. The parrot became a regular visitor to the garden and veranda. And whenever it saw Aunt Ruby, it would call out, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, and can't dance." The parrot had learned to talk after all. So what happened next? When the parrot called Aunt Ruby useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance, she became really angry and her face turned red and she ran away inside her room. But story doesn't end here. After this incident, the parrot daily used to come to the garden and used to sit in the veranda. And whenever he was seeing Aunt Ruby, it will shout, "You are useless, can't talk, can't sing, and can't dance." Why? Because that's what he has learned from Aunt Ruby. That's what she used to say all the time to the parrot. "He is just a bird. He has a God's gift of imitating human voice. He doesn't know the meaning of those words." So, he used to repeat that. So, in the end, at last, like this, parrot finally learned to talk. So, what do we learn from this story, students? The karma does matter. whatever we do, it comes back to us in this way or another way. So before saying anything, before speaking anything or anything bad, we should think. Because whatever bad thing, bad karma we will do, it will come back to us only. So always be nice, speak nice and behave nicely. So our story ends here. So let's go through the word meanings. Refused means was not willing. Bird catcher, a person who caught birds. Insisted, did not listen and argued. Knocked, struck. Winging, flying. Veranda, an open space in front of the house with a railing around it. Squawk, a loud noise made by a bird. The sharp sound which the bird made, that is called squawk. Making connections. These are the fill-ups giving under the heading making connections. This story tells us something about parrots. Complete the following sentences. Parrots can imitate human beings. You all know that. Parrots like eating green chilies, ripe tomatoes and mangoes. Parrots don't like living in a cage. The sound that a parrot makes is called a squawk. When a parrot is sitting on a branch or a twig, we say that it is perched. So students, now let's do the word wall. If you see in your book on page number 57, some pictures of the birds is given, like cuckoo, woodpecker, crane, flamingo, hornbill, peacock, pigeon, bulbul, owl and eagle. And a crossword puzzle is also given there. I cannot give all these things here, so I am writing only answers according to the puzzle. First, I am going to tell you the puzzles solved across. With the help of the picture dictionary, complete the crossword given below. A bird that hoots means bird which makes hooting sounds, owl. A brown song bird, bulbul. A bird of prey that soars high in the sky. Which bird flies very high in the sky and hunts? It's eagle. A tall, long-legged bird that is usually brown, white or grey. It is crane. It is the most common bird you can find near any water body. And fish is crane's favorite food. National bird of India. What it is, kids? You all must be knowing it. Yes. The beautiful bird is peacock. Number 10. A bird that lays its eggs in the nest of other birds. Which bird lays its eggs in the nest of other birds? Cuckoo. Yes, cuckoo lays its eggs in the nest of crows. And crows take care of cuckoo's eggs thinking that it's his own eggs, his own kids. Now comes the second part of the crossword puzzles. All the answers which will be marked from up to down will be given in this slide as I have already written down. So the answer of number 1 is A bird with a large curved beak. Curved, slightly curved, bent. Its hornbill. A bird that pecks all day long. It is woodpecker. A bird that carried letters from one place to another in old days. You must have seen in the movies also. Yes, it is pigeon. A pink water bird. It is flamingo. Now let's start our grammar time. On page number 58, some rules are given. According to those rules, we have to use is or are according to the situation. So, we use is with the singular and are with the plural verb. What are the verbs which are singular? I, she, it, he. These all are singular. And plural, we and they. With I, we always use am. And this happens in present continuous tense. Plus, we use ing in the verb. Now on page number 59, some pictures are given in your book where you have to fill some blanks with the help of is or are. So, I have written those sentences as answers only without pictures. Let's go through them. The teacher is telling a story because the teacher is a singular. So, we have used verb is. Tom and Anne are turning wheels. Tom and Anne are two people. So, they are plural. So, we have used verb are. The ants are marching up the hill. Ants means noun is plural. So, we are using helping verb also plural, which is are. The stars are twinkling in the sky. Again, stars are plural. So, we will use the helping verb are. Page number 59 itself, question number 2 is there. Some pictures are given and speech bubbles are given. We have to make a sentence. The people in the pictures are describing actions that are going on at the time of speaking, which means it is in present tense, like we have done in the last slide. Same rules will be applied here. Fill in the speech bubbles using a helping verb plus a main verb with ing, means we will use ing with the main verb. The first speech bubble is we, and the picture, the kids are playing football. So, we are playing basketball. Sorry, it's basketball. In the second speech bubble, in front of it up in the picture, the girl is drinking something. So, we will make the sentence, I am drinking a glass of water. In the next picture, a bird is feeding its chicks and a girl and a boy is standing down. So, in the speech bubble, we will write, the birds are chirping. In the next picture, a boy and a girl is standing and the girl is painting the wall. So, in the speech bubble, we will write, Anu is painting the wall. Is helping verb, paint is main verb, and ing will put, so it will become a complete sentence. Anu is painting the wall. Now on page number 60 is given, write the plural form of the following words. In grammar, you have already gone through singular and plural. Singular means one, plural means more than one. So let's start. Wolf, wolves. Shelf, shelves. Hoof, hooves. Leaf, leaves. Knife, knives. Scarf, scarves. What is common in all these words, students? Yes. In the singular, the last word is F. And when we make the plural, the F changes into VES. In what F changes? In VES. So wolf becomes wolves and shelf becomes shelves. So our next activity is write well. Composition. Some clues are already given. On the basis of that, we have to make a paragraph using those clues. Choose a bird you would like to write about. Fill in the blanks given below with the points that you can think of. Then write a short composition on the bird. So, I have not written it in a fill-up form. I have directly written it in a paragraph form. So, with the help of the clues, this is the paragraph which have come forward. We have chosen the bird cuckoo. A cuckoo has a slender body with long tail and narrow wings. Slender means slim. It has short legs and its feathers are very soft. A cuckoo call is the reason for its name. It sounds like somebody is mocking a cuckoo sound. It is found mainly in Europe and Asia. Usually it eats insects, larvae and fruits, but its favorite diet is caterpillars. So, now let's discuss our question answers. We have already gone through the chapters, explain it. So, you must be aware with most of the answers. Before starting any question answer, a small line is given and these questions are based on that line. So, that line is, one day the parrot suddenly dived forward and knocked off Aunt Ruby's spectacles off a nose. Now these questions are based on this line. You can get clues from this line. The first question is, how had Aunt Ruby got the parrot? From where did she got the parrot? Yes, Aunt Ruby got the parrot from a bird catcher. From where? From a bird catcher. Question number two, what did Aunt Ruby want the parrot to learn? What did she want the parrot to learn? Aunt Ruby wanted the parrot to learn to talk. That's why Aunt Ruby used to teach him, na? Now, question number C. Why do you think the parrot knocked Aunt Ruby's spectacles off her nose? Why did he that? The parrot knocked Aunt Ruby's spectacles because he was angry at her. And why he was angry at her? Because he didn't like her. She used to force him to speak. She used to shout on him. And because of that, parrots also started disliking her. That's why the parrot knocked her spectacle off. Question number 3. One afternoon, while everyone was in the dining room, I gave the parrot his lunch. Now, let's start the question answer. The narrator is the person who tells us a story, who put the narrator in charge of feeding the parrot. Who put the narrator in charge? Think. Yes. The narrator's grandmother put him in charge of feeding the parrot. What mistake did the narrator make after giving the parrot its lunch? The narrator had left the cage open. What happened because of this mistake? The parrot escaped as a result of the narrator's mistake. Because he left the cage open, the parrot flew away, no? So it happened because of narrator's mistake. So that's all for today, kids. The parrot who would not talk, story is over. We have done most of the exercises, though not all exercises. Whatever is remaining, I will give you in a PDF form. You have to do all this work, question answers in your copy and remaining work according to your subject teacher's instruction. This is the picture of the parrot I imagined. So, good luck with your studies. Do the reading 2 times at home. Try to understand and pronounce each word. This will improve your reading and develop reading habits in you. If you are stuck about any word, use the dictionary. You can find that word's answer there. It will develop your vocabulary also. So, the must thing you have to do is do this chapter's reading entirely at least 2 times.